For this next story, maybe you should hum the Kansas song, Dust in the Wind, because dust from the Saharan Desert is blanketing now the Caribbean, and it's not stopping there. Fox 2 meteorologist Angela Huddy is live to explain the dust and how it might end up in our skies. Angela?
And in those Kansas skies as well. That's right. Hey there, Glenn. Yes, we are talking about thunderstorms on the other side of the world and how they have sent that dust on a nearly 5,000-mile journey to the United States. Dust from the Sahara Desert is forecasted to make its way to the St. Louis region by Friday. Downdrafts from thunderstorms over Africa blow the dust high in the air, where it gets picked up by trade winds in the upper levels of the atmosphere. Most of the time, that dust settles out over the open ocean, but when the conditions are right, it carries all the way across the Atlantic. While it typically reaches parts of South America, the Caribbean, and the U.S. Gulf Coast, dust spreading into the central United States is more rare. Much like when wildfire smoke drifts into our region, we'll notice a haze to the sky this weekend. Those extra particulates in the atmosphere do a great job of scattering the sun's rays, creating beautiful sunrises and sunsets. Rob Muller with Schiller's Camera says that while a mirrorless camera or digital SLR would be the best to capture that moment, the best camera is the one that's with you.
Many of the cameras, and even on some cell phones, have an actual sunset setting. And that is very helpful because what the camera does is it tries to give you, it tailors the settings for sunrise, sunsets, which tends to give you a little longer exposure and a little bit better aperture, a little bit better f-stop, so more things are in focus.
While it can be beautiful, all that extra dust in the air can also be dangerous to those who live with respiratory issues. Chris Martinez, executive director of the Asthma and Allergy Foundation of St. Louis, says that means asking the most vulnerable to once again stay inside.
Of course, if someone has a respiratory challenge already, it could very well be even more difficult. So we're talking about irritation to the throat, the nose, the eyes. Obviously, that can lead to more serious situations, you know, classically known as an asthma attack. So we're very concerned about our folks and making sure that people are prepared.
And of course, wearing a mask can help with that as well. One of my favorite facts about dust from the Sahara, it actually helps feed the plants of the Amazon rainforest. The Sahara was once a lake bed, and the phosphorus that is in that dust, well, NASA scientists have proved that it is an essential nutrient that helps keep the Amazon so fertile. So our globe is definitely an amazing place. Live tonight, I'm meteorologist Angela Huddy, Fox 2 News.
All right, Angela, thank you.